Previously, we've used Rust compiler RustC to compile Rust code into a native binary that we could run on our machine. Rust developers, however, rarely invoke the compiler directly. Instead, they use a tool called Cargo. Cargo is Rust's build tool, dependency manager, test runner, and project bootstrapper all rolled into one. So even though you can use Rust from a third-party build tool like Make, this is almost never necessary. Cargo offers an easy and intuitive way of building and running all of your Rust projects. Let's take a look at how to use it. If you've installed Rust through RustUp, you should already have Cargo installed on your machine. We'll use Cargo to create a new project for us using Cargo New. We'll call the project Cargo Hello World. Cargo has created everything we need for a new project. First, there's a cargo.toml file, which, as we'll soon see, is a simple manifest file describing metadata about our project, including its name, version, dependencies, and more. Next, there's a source directory with a single file, main.rs. This is where our Rust code lives. Cargo has also initialized the directory as a Git repository. Cargo has been friendly enough to pre-populate our main.rs file with some Hello World boilerplate. Rust makes it easy to write Hello World. We don't even have to write the code ourselves. To build this project, we can run cargo build. This builds a debug version of our binary and puts it in a newly created target directory in the debug subdirectory. We can run our binary directly as before. Cargo provides a convenient shortcut for building and running our project by running cargo run. We can even run tests for our project with cargo test, although our Hello World project doesn't have any tests yet. Now that we know how to use Cargo directly, let's open up this project in Visual Studio Code. Before we get started writing code, I'm going to install the Rust Analyzer extension for VS Code. This augments VS Code with features specific to Rust, including IntelliSense and inline compiler error annotations, so we know when we've typed something wrong. Rust Analyzer is the best tool for using Rust in VS Code, and it will soon replace the older Rust extension, which we won't need. When Rust Analyzer prompts us to do so, we'll need to hit the Install button to download and install the separate Rust Analyzer binary that powers the extension. Now that Rust Analyzer is installed, we can get started writing Rust.